Finding those items that stand out but are still affordable means time in the van to hunt them down. And today it's a 300-mile trip to Paddock Wood in Kent to visit a new antique market.
Right then, T, so we're in Kent and we're off to the Big Brocante. Okay. It's a new fair. It's only been on once before, heard good things. New fairs bring out a lot of new dealers and first-timers.
Yeah.
And that brings out the good stuff.
Situated in the Kent countryside is the Hop Farm, which is home to the largest collection of Victorian Oast houses in the world. It's also the venue of the Big Brocante Antiques Market, where there are 100 stalls with dealers from all over the country coming to sell the best of their antiques, vintage and decorative pieces. It's only the second time the market has taken place, so it's a first for Drew and a great opportunity.
That bus is mega, isn't it? Is that
It's a food place.
Wow.
Coming to these markets, it's almost like having everybody here working for you, because they're all out doing miles and miles, spending money and time, and I'm able to come here and just go that, that, that. So it really saves me an awful lot of time. That's why these fairs are so good.
What have you gone for there?
Bacon, egg.
And brown sauce?
Brown. Always
brown. Brown sauce day, is it?
Always brown. I never don't like red.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Look at that.
Some mixes.
Great pair of planters. That's brilliant.
Imagine the swearing they've seen.
When he started out in the trade, Drew spent years working markets like this and still has a soft spot for them today.
There's nothing more fun than wandering around an antique fair. Bacon sarnie, have a coffee, do a good bit of buying. I love this stuff. Look at that.
He's beautiful, isn't,
isn't it great?
He's terrific.
Yeah.
How much is he?
He's 90.
He's lovely.
Everybody does exactly what you've
do
done. Yeah. He's so tactile. It's
he used
amazing.
To be that high.
That's it, that's it. Yeah, he's worn him down over time.
There's this thing I kept looking at and keep touching, this beautiful buffalo or bison, and it's just great looking, and I can't take my hands off it. So if I can't, somebody else is going to feel the same, aren't they? And it's 90 quid. I think I can get 180. I think I can double up.
This modernist-looking bull was made by Ruschka, a German company that was a prolific maker of lava glaze pottery in the 1960s and 70s. The finish gets its name because the texture and appearance mimics that of volcanic lava as it cools. West German pottery like this is becoming increasingly popular. It could be worth around £200.
I've got to have him.
You're going to have him?
I've got to have him, yeah. Thank you very much.
OK, I'll take your money.
I can't not have him.
The benefit of antique markets is that they attract a fantastic mix of established dealers and some Drew's done business with before.
Nice to see you.
Nice to see you too.
One stand just jumped straight out at me. I thought, oh, look at that. That looks like good gear. Straight over to it. It's a dealer I know, Sophie. Done business with her in the past. This is somebody who knows what they're doing.
I like your row of men.
Do you want to be part of the collection?
There's some great ones there.
Which ones do you like best?
I like all four.
Yeah. Do you want a price for the four?
He's a strange one, isn't he? She's got three mustachioed gents on the right-hand side, then another guy in army sort of uniform. He's a little odd-looking, I think. Not himself, I'm sure he's fine, but the painting's just not good enough. The other three are good, particularly the very small one.
Give us a price for the four. I might duck out on him, but only... But,
OK. £200. But £450 if you don't like him.
I've been buying ugly blokes on canvas and board for decades. I love them. They're great.
Yeah, it's tight, isn't it?
They seem to be fetching more and more. They're really going up and up.
Really?
In price.
I'll tell you what, I'll take those three.
All right.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Marvellous, right. Thank you.
Right. I bought all three of the paintings for 350 quid. So basically, I'm spread betting. You know, I'm sort of going, well, if I'm going to make money on that one for sure, but I want to charge a little bit more for this one, and that one I might break even through. Because what I'll do, I'll group those on the wall as one in the shop.
Drew spotted a few other things he's keen to get his hands on.
Is this all yours as well?
Yeah, that's all.
This little modernist chair thing here.
140, Drew.
Is there anything about it?
Eh?
What is it?
It's got a maker's. It's Italian.
No age to it, is it? It's 80s, is it?
80s, yeah.
80s. How much is that for?
140. It just had an unusual shape. Yeah. It's not really the kind of thing I actually buy.
No, I think I'd get 180 out of it, so yeah, we'll have that.
Yeah,
yeah, yeah. Marvellous, thanks.
You shouldn't buy single chairs unless they stand out on their own. It's called sitting well in the room, and it should look good from every single angle. That one does.
What about this pair of chairs?
180.
And the little table?
90.
Okay. And that one?
I like that one. 120.
This garden potting table is French in origin and dates back to the 1960s. Made from steel, it features numerous layers of heavily worn paint that have been applied over the years. It could be worth around £175.
Yes. Though, again, we're not making fortunes here, but it's a steady drip-drip of profit.
So far, the market is delivering exactly what Drew wanted, which is a great selection of quality items that won't break the bank.
Nothing wrong with a bit of brown furniture?
No.
It's nice, isn't it? Hello.
Hello.
Can that be £100?
What have I got on for you? Oh, I should think so, seeing as it's you.
Thank you.
Lovely. That one, there's about £80 left in that one for us. So it's all adding up, you know? It's a profitable little day. If you start just ticking away, the hundreds add up.
With hundreds of dealers wanting to do business...
That's nice.
Drew's spoiled for choice.
For sure?
Yeah. How much is it?
£50.
£50?
Yeah.
Damn. Marvellous.
How much is it?
£50.
What this is, it's a hanging pendant, like, for a dark room. So, yeah, never bought one before. What do you say, £40?
Yeah, I don't know, so.
Thank you. Marvellous. He says £50, and I said, oh, hang on, what was that? Did you say 40? Yes, deal. A bit of fun, and get it bought, £40. Get it rewired, it's very individual. There's a proper profit left in that one. It's cool, isn't it? Oh.
£65.
So, yeah, yeah, I love that. Another good buy, little painted tubular stool, adjustable, original Rexine covering to the seat, which is a faux leather. You might remember old Ford Anglias used to have that as their interior.